Hello. So I am doing this TikTok makeup challenge. It's like makeup roulette. I just bought a bunch of palettes, so I gave my friends a bunch of random numbers and random colors, and I just threw them together, and this is what I'm going to do with it. It's just a regular drag makeup look. I think it's just going to be a regular drag makeup look. I'm not really sure where we're going with it, but if you would like to see it, stick around, because where else are we going? So I've gone on ahead and blocked out my brows off camera, and here I am redrawing my new, higher, more arched brow in green with Mehron aqua colors and an angled brush. And we're moving on and doing the same thing here on the other side, really trying to work on my symmetry. Now we are evening them out and making them look a little bit more like sisters and instead of cousins. And using aqua colors, we don't really need to set them, but here I'm going to use a little bit of the green from the Glam Light paint palette, and I'm just gonna add a little dimension. Then to deepen that up a little bit more, I'm going to use a darker green from the James Charles palette. Really just sculpting and defining that brow. Now I am using a lighter concealer and I'm carving out my brow bone. Those eyebrows become a little more pronounced. I'm doing the same on top to sculpt those out. Now I'm taking more of the concealer and just blending that out, really highlighting my brow bone, trying to conceal my brows. And now I am blending everything out with a little. Going back in with a little black on the tail ends of these brows. Here I am blending out that concealer that I put on my lids. Here I'm taking Fuchsia from the Glam Light Paints palette. Brushing that all over my brow bone. Now I'm using Layla from the Juvia's Place Nubia 2 palette. And I'm just using that to smoke out Fuchsia. With a smaller brush, I'm taking more of that Layla and making it more intense. Now here I've taken more concealer and put that all over my lid. And with a flat concealer brush, I am really just cutting that crease, pulling that skin back, make it taut. Here I am using a flat brush and packing on more of that fuchsia. And now I'm taking Layla with an angled brush and like blending it forward. Now I'm taking a little bit more of my highlight powder and pack that underneath my brows. Using a much smaller brush to detail that crease. And finally, we're gonna wing out these eyes. Make sure to make your eyes massive. Like, no human on earth could have eyes this big. Going back in with concealer, I'm cleaning up all of our lines, making things sharp and cute. Now I'm taking a very small pointed brush and some crown white. I'm making our eyes a little bit larger by painting on the inner corner. Smoke out these eyes. Now it's time to do a little color correction. Take some of this tiger orange and just blend that all over the beard area. Anywhere hair grows, you just want to make sure to block out the blue from your beard. Now we're gonna pack it on. They don't call it pancake for nothing. And dust away any excess. Now it's time for a little Krylon TV paint stick. After we've put it on the skin, we are now blending with a synthetic brush. And that's my favorite word, blending. Yep, you guessed it. More blending. Gotta pack that down. Brush away any excess. Now I'm color correcting here. I am using yellow to color correct under my eyes, the bridge of my nose, my cupid's bow, the highest point of my cheekbones, and just a little on my chin. Here I'm using my lightest highlight shade, and I'm putting that on top of all of the spots where I put yellow. Now I'm taking my second highlight shade, and I am making a V on my face, under my nose, on my forehead, on my cheek, just under my cheekbone. And now I am blending everything. Always remember, when using a blending sponge, it has to be a little moist. Now I'm using a wide flat brush to brush on my first contour shade. Being sure to blend upward on my cheeks ever so slightly and down on my forehead. Here I'm shaving my jaw back just a little to cheat the eye, to give the illusion of a smaller jaw. Now I'm taking my second contour shade and placing that on the bridge of my nose, behind my nostrils, on my cheekbones, my forehead, and below my lip. Now I'm just going and blending everything. I use a different blending sponge. You don't necessarily have to. I just like to be a little OCD. Using a triangle sponge to blend my nose. Now it's time to do some cooking. Placing some loose setting powder under your nose, on the highest point of your chin, your cupid's bow, and the bridge of your nose. And I like to add an additional bit under my neck and to help cut that cheek right there under my cheekbones. I'm gonna use Madagascar from the Juvia's Place Nubian Chew Palette to blend out my contour. Remember how I said blending was my favorite word? Yep, you got it. Still blending. Now I'm going to dust away all of the excess loose powder. I'm going in with a larger, fluffier brush and blending those contours forward even more. Same with the jawbone. Now, in order to force the darker colors back, we're going to add the darkest brown that we have in our palette. No, don't be afraid. I'm using a flat, wide artist brush to apply my second contour, being sure to add it on the jaw, at the temples, and under the lip, and behind the nostrils. And again, back to our favorite word, blending. Small circular motions all over your face. Now I'm using my little trick to draw on my lips. By using the side of my pencil, I'm able to get a much sharper line than I would if I were using the point, which dulls very quickly. And to draw my top lip, I'm adding a dot at the beginning, in the center, and at the end, and connecting these dots to make my overdrawn lips connect. Then I fill it all in with pencil and top it with a nice deep purple lipstick. I pop a little concealer in the center just to give a little nude illusion. And now I'm taking the Nubian 2 palette and adding a little shimmer to the high points of my cheek and my nose with Nefertiti. Always time for a little drink. Ooh, it's looking good. Now it's time for some booby contour. We're adding both of our highlight shades and then blending outward. Then we'll be using that same wide flat contour brush and we're just drawing a little martini shape. We take a blending sponge and just blend it. Pop on some of that loose setting powder. Get that Madagascar out again, and you got it. Blend. Again, we're gonna go back in with our contour detail brush, flatten it out, add a little shimmer. Pop on a mole. Smoke out a little under the eyes, just adding a little extra dimension. Wide flat.
Okay, so here she is. This is the all put together, all dolled up to go nowhere quarantina look that I got to put together today. She was fun. She's been cute. Yeah, thanks for watching.
No, like my ex, you got to go. I want all my money up front. If you don't, guess what? I'm gonna have an attitude. Got an attitude.